I'm super excited for today's video. I'm going to be showing you guys how I created this look right here. Recently, I posted a makeup tutorial of a monochromatic green look. I was obsessed. You guys loved it. Like, it's probably one of my most liked pictures on Instagram. By the way, if you don't follow me on Instagram, go follow me. I post all my makeup looks on there and I'm super active, so be sure that you follow me on Instagram. But yeah, so in that video, I did ask you guys if you wanted to see other color combos. Let me know, and you guys said yes, and I was like, girl, thank you. Okay, I just needed the a-okay so that way when I sit down and film these videos, because I'm obsessed with monochromatic looks. I think they're so beautiful. So I was like, girl, you want to see them? I got you. And I did also see a few comments that you guys wanted to see the color orange next. So here I am with the orange look. This look is a little bit different. The green one was more of a rounded eye, whereas the orange one today is more of that elongated, super winged out eye look. But I absolutely love it. I think it's beautiful. And for today's look, I did dip into the new Be Perfect Scepter palette. And this is what the palette looks like right here. It's so beautiful. If you guys seen my unboxing video, you did see that I did unbox this. And I am obsessed, you guys. It is so good. Be Perfect Cosmetics is the brand that created the Stacey Marie palettes. And you guys know that's one of my most used palettes on my channel in general. Like, I love them. So I knew that this palette was going to be bomb as far as the formula. And honestly, it didn't disappoint, obviously. So there's only two oranges in this palette. So I did dip into my Love Tahiti palette just a little bit. But majority of it is from this palette here. I also did try out a few of the Jaclyn Hill cosmetic stuff. I did get these things a while ago and haven't gotten to use them. You guys, I get so much makeup and I have one face. Like, I need to sit down and remind myself that it's gonna be impossible for me to use all this stuff right away. So I'm trying my best, you guys. I promise you, I'm trying my best that every single time I do a haul video or I show you guys new things on Instagram, that I am featuring them in a video so we can try them out together. So I did use a few Jaclyn Hill cosmetic stuff today. I also tried out the Beauty Creations foundation powder. So there's a couple new things in today's video, but overall, we're really focusing on that monochromatic orange look. I hope you guys are excited. Before we jump into today's video, I did wanna just mention my lip combo. I didn't show it on camera. It's the same exact lip combo that I always wear. So I'm wearing the KKW lip liner in the shade nude number 2. It's the perfect nude for my skin tone. I freaking love it. I'm also wearing the Laura Lee Los Angeles liquid lipstick in the shade Nakey Nakey. Do I really have to tell you? And then I did apply a little bit of the Jeffree Star liquid lipstick in the shade I'm Nude just in the center to lighten up that lip combo. Then I went over with the KKW lip gloss in the shade nude 2. And then the last thing that I used, which is what's giving me kind of like that reverse ombre that you guys know I kind of love to do, this right here is the P. Louise base in the shade OTT orange. So these are basically cream bases, you guys. They're so versatile. You can use it on the eyes, you can use it in your waterline, on your lips, as a blush. Like, they literally are able to do everything. So that's why I always am like, girl, you need to pick these up, not just the original one that you guys see me use as eyeshadow base, but even the color ones are so helpful, and I promise you, you're gonna get so much use out of these. By the way, you would think this video is like sponsored, but it's not. I just genuinely love them. So that's what I'm wearing in the center of my lips in case you guys were interested to know. And yeah, so what do you guys think about this look? I think it's pretty. Down below in the comments, definitely let me know what color you guys want to see next. I was thinking of doing pink next or purple, but I don't really know. You guys definitely let me know because you guys recommended for me to do an orange. So here I am. So let me know what color we are going to do next. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump to today's video. Before we jump in, please don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you guys have not already, okay? It's free. I bring you guys some bomb makeup looks. We're always trying new things. Definitely subscribe to your girl's channel if this is the first time that you're seeing my video. Hello, nice to meet you. My name is Tatanisha. I'm obsessed with makeup, buying makeup, doing makeup on myself, and it's just chit-chatting and having a good time on my channel. And of course, without further ado, if you guys would like to see how I created this makeup look today, then just keep on watching. Alright, you guys, so let's go ahead and get into today's look. By the way, I do have the air conditioner on. You guys, it's so hot in here. So I'm sorry if you guys can hear the noise of that. Please just try to ignore it. So I'm starting off with my P. Louise base in the shade Rumor Number 2. I like to just dot a few dots of that on my entire eyelid, and then I go in with a Morphe buffing brush just to go ahead and blend out that shadow base. Now, this is a base that you do not want to set. You want it to be a little tacky, so that way it adheres to your eyeshadows. So moving on to the Be Perfect palette, this is the Scepter palette. So beautiful. The shades in here are absolutely stunning, and I'm going to be using those two orange shades, of course. The first shade is called Orange Peel. It's a beautiful neon orange, and you guys, it's so pigmented. You guys can see right here, like, the shadow speaks for itself. It is so beautiful, so vibrant, very bright, and you guys, I was able to pack it on pretty heavily, as you guys can see here, and there was no patchiness, nothing. There was no inconsistency with the shadow whatsoever. It was really nice, and I really enjoyed it. So I took a small detail brush just to make sure I can pack it on as much as I can. You guys know I like to start with my intense colors and then blend it out towards my brow bone. So now what I'm going to do is go into the shade called LV, and this is just the lighter orange, and I'm going to use that to start to buff out that harsh edge that I created with that first orange shadow. So those two oranges were perfect. Those are the two shades that I used in that palette for now. So moving on, so that way we can do some further blending, I'm going to go in with the Be Perfect Love Tahiti palette, and I'm going to be using the two orange shades at the top. So I actually just mixed the two together on a big, fluffy, yet blending brush. And of course, I just went ahead and diffused that darker orange. So keep in mind, even though we're using a whole bunch of orange shades, you do need different undertones of the orange, so that way you can get a really nice blend. So I'm also going into that dark brown shade in the Love Tahiti palette, and this is just going to give us some definition. The oranges were just a little bit too bright. I wanted something to deepen up the crease a little bit so we have some sort of dimension in there. So that's what I did there. And then honestly, after that, it's just a continuation of blending, 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 because as you guys can see, we're just working with one tone. So you want to make sure everything looks really nice and seamless. So moving on to cutting the crease, I'm using this one right here from P. Louise. This is one of their crisp finish bases. So these bases here have a formula of blank canvas. They're just colored bases, which are amazing. So I did go ahead and cut my crease with this shade. I will tell you guys the shade down below in the description box, and I'll try to post it in the video as well in case you guys are interested. So there is the crease, nice and cut. And as you guys can see, it's like a light orange, like creamsicle color. So it's perfect, and it's going to make sure that that orange that we put on top really pops. So now what I'm going to do is go into that lighter orange in the Love Tahiti palette, and that's the shade that I'm going to use to put on my entire lid. You guys, this look would be absolutely stunning as well if you wanted to do like a shimmer gold or like a shimmer orange on the lid. That would have looked really beautiful as well. I ended up putting shimmer in the inner corner because I kind of love the matte look. You guys know most of my colorful looks are always matte, but a shimmer would be absolutely gorgeous. So what I did for the outer corner is I basically just went back in with all of those oranges again, and the last shade that I went in with was that deeper brown just to make sure it looks nice and intense. And then now I'm going to go ahead and add some L'Oreal Air Volume. You guys know I love this mascara lately. It's amazing. And then the lashes that I'm wearing are the OMG lashes in the style Glam On. One of my favorites. I've been obsessed with them. They're perfect and they go with any look. So here are the eyes for now. Let's go ahead and move on to the face. So for my under eyes, I wanted to start off with the Jaclyn Hill Eye Primer. I believe it's the under eye primer. And this was really nice. This is what the packaging looks like. It does have a metal applicator tip, so it's extremely cooling underneath the eyes. It felt really nice. It was very smooth. I don't know that I've seen a huge difference with my under eyes once I put on concealer, but I feel like I have to try it a few more times. But overall, it was actually really nice. So moving on to primer, I'm going to be using the Laura Mercier Illuminating Primer. This thing makes your skin look like glass. It's beautiful. And then for foundation, I wanted to mix these two. One is the Uma Beauty Say What Foundation. The other one is the Hard Candy Glamouflage Foundation. The Hard Candy one you can find at Walmart, and the Uma Beauty you can get on Ulta's website. I don't know the shade of the Uma Beauty one that I'm wearing, you guys. I have to look on my Ulta app because the shade is not on the bottle. The sticker came off. But if I can find the exact shade, I'll go ahead and leave it down below in the description box in case you guys are about my skin tone. But girl, that combo, sickening. Moving on to cream bronzer, I'm going to be using the Danessa Myricks cream bronzer in the shade Light. Love this cream bronzer. It blends really well, and the color just suits my skin tone really well. I feel like it gives me the perfect amount of bronze without looking muddy, and it's just really beautiful and blends really well. So I usually cream bronze my cheeks. Whatever's left on my brush, I'll go and just like kind of cream bronze my nose a little bit. Cream contouring my nose is not really my forte, so moving on. I'm going to be using the Jouer Essential High Coverage Concealer. This is one of my favorite concealers of all time. There is nothing in my collection that has coverage quite like this, and it's just absolutely beautiful. I use mine in the shade Cream Cafe. This is a brand new tube. I've went through two already, which is insane. Moving on to liquid blush, I wanted to use this Blush from Mama Mitchell. You guys, this shade is popping, okay? You want to talk about a pop of orange? Honey, this is next level. It is so beautiful, and it was so perfect for today's look. I was so obsessed. As you guys can see, that color makes a statement. So moving on to setting underneath my eyes, I wanted to try out the Jaclyn Hill Cosmetics Brightening Eye Palette. You guys, this is such a nice palette, and this was the first time that I was ever using a pressed powder to set underneath my eyes, and as you guys can see, it gave me not only brightness, but smoothness. You guys, it was so nice. Now, the palette itself, because it's white, it got all dirty and disgusting around the powders because I'm using a big sponge, but oh my goodness, it's so good. Like, look at that. Amazing. So to set the rest of my face, I wanted to try out the Beauty Creations Stay Flawless Powder Foundation, and this was nice. I don't feel like it made a huge impact for some reason. Like, it was okay, but it wasn't like, oh my gosh, you need to go get it like right now. But I will try it a few times. This was only the first time I was trying it, so I'll definitely keep you guys updated if I end up changing my mind. Moving on to bronzer, I'm going to be using the Essence Sun Club Matte Bronzing Palette. I know you guys are probably tired of seeing me use this, but it is so good and it's so inexpensive. It was even recently on sale at Ulta for $5, which is insane. You get 4 shades in here. It's bomb. You need it. For blush today, I decided to go in with the Sephora Collection blush in the shade Love Child, a beautiful peachy pink blush. It was perfect. I was obsessed, you guys. I think it came out so beautiful. I love the combo of this and the Mama Mitchell liquid blush. I thought they were beautiful together. So moving on to the next Jaclyn Hill product, this is her loose powders, I'm guessing. And you guys, this was so pigmented. So in her video, she actually used it to clean up her bronzer, like what I'm doing here. But oh my gosh, this was so pigmented that when I went to wipe it off my face, you guys, it would not come off. Like, I had to go in with the foundation powder because my face was white. Like, it was insanely pigmented. So I have to really practice with it to see exactly how to use this powder, so that way, you know, I can kind of explain it to you guys, because it was a little difficult, not gonna lie. So while that was sitting there baking, I did go in and just wing out that shadow. So I like to start with the dark shade, the light shade, and then the lightest shade to blow it out towards my temple. As far as you want to go, it's personal preference. But I like to do this sometimes once my foundation and everything is done, because you can do it before, but then you have to do double the work because you'll have to go over it anyway. So that's just a little tip. So now with the lower lash line, I just went in with that super bright neon orange, and then I'm using a ColourPop cream gel liner. I will leave the name to the liner down below in the description box, but it's just a really pretty neon bright orange. I was absolutely obsessed, and it was absolutely perfect. A yellow liner would have looked good too, but I wanted to keep it monochromatic, so we went with an orange. Then I was like, girl, I forgot highlight. So for highlight, I'm using the Gilded Honey Highlighter from Laura Geller. Super pretty. This is my favorite highlighter of all time. It just looks wet on the skin. It sinks right in. It doesn't settle. It's beautiful. And then I took a little bit of that bright orange eyeshadow from the Scepter palette, and I applied that as a blush as well, just to combine the eyes and the cheeks together. And I was like, yes, girl, this is the look I was going for. So I did the lips off camera. In the intro, I told you guys exactly what the lip combo is. And now to set my face, I'm using the Huda Beauty Glow Coconut Setting Spray. This setting spray did me dirty. Do you guys see those big patches of setting spray? It was a mission to get that to dry down and not ruin my foundation, but in the end, the look turned out absolutely stunning. What do you guys think of this monochromatic look? I think it came out so beautiful. Down below in the comments, let me know what color you guys want to see next. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye, guys.